Health Research Facility, where we are committed, no pun intended, to helping sick people resolve their problems and become normal, functioning members of society.
Founded in 1958 and boasting a remarkable 247-bed capacity, this institution, the main wing of which you see behind me here, has gained an impressive reputation in the mental health community for having some of the most innovative and successful treatment programs for the socially maladjusted and criminally insane. With a staff including 17 psychiatrists, 33 psychologists, licensed clinical social workers and therapists, and 45 nurses and aides in addition to our support staff, we utilize a variety of approaches in our treatments in order to meet the patient's individual needs.
One of the staff members now. Understanding of how our patients live, let's take a tour of the facility. A very nice recreational facility. What do you do here?
Pass straight.
Wasn't that decapitation?
No.
Very nice. We will now be entering the main lounge, where our patients spend most of their free time.
Carolina Alternator, what is he doing here? I didn't think he was coming down to this ward and never saving since after what happened to old May Calanza.
This is Nurse Bobby May. How are
Carolina?
You?
Carolina?
Yes.
Have you read the Book of Gideon?
Not today. Would you like to tell them about this room?
It's a lounge.
And what do our patients do here?
Well, at 10 a.m. every morning, they come in for their pills. They got the red, the blue, the we give them Book of Gideon as they get their pills. And say about 10-15 minutes later, they get real, real calm. And they sit kind of like knots on a log in front of this television right here. They watch the comedies, the westerns. Well, when I'm on patrol and they're on good behavior, I let them watch Pat Robertson. And later on in the day, 3 to 4, we got family hour. And that consists at they check the patients out at 3, and they have them back by 4. We don't care where they go, what they do, as long as they're back by 4. From 4 to 6, we got what we call mandatory fun time. We sit in a huge, big old circle, and we talk about our feelings, how we can keep our hands to ourselves, how we can keep from hurting ourselves and from hurting others. And then we got ourselves a variety of activities. We can read a book, like Gideon. We can write in a journal. Even play some foosball.
Is that what this room is for?
Thank you.
Our tour, I'd like to introduce you to one of our head psychiatric researchers here, Dr. Franklin Bazil. Let's go find him. Hello, Dr. Bazil.
Oh, good evening.
I was hoping you could tell our guests about some of your more experimental research.
Well, that's an interesting question, Carlita. We're working on several major projects right now, mostly new therapeutic techniques. But our biggest and most revolutionary is what we like to call the pathway through the mind.
You see, therapy as we know it can take years, even decades to even find out what is wrong with the patient, let alone cure him or her. This is for various reasons. Patients very often cannot identify, let alone express, their feelings. Without knowing these, it is impossible to get to the source of psychosis, and without getting deep into the core of the problem, there is little hope of being able to solve it. This is especially difficult in such cases as violent psychotics, for instance.
Therefore, my team and I have been working on developing a system with which we can actually enter the mind of the criminally insane individual and view their innermost thoughts, fears, and demons, which can cause them to commit the most unspeakable acts. Basically, the technique is about knowing more about the mind of the psychopath, obtaining that knowledge faster, and therefore being able to more quickly implement a cure.
What stage is the experiment in?
Well, let us go in and observe. Nurse?
Doctor.
Thank you. We've passed through the preliminary stages and will now be testing on live subjects.
What kind of result do you expect, Doctor?
Well, we're completely uncertain what we will find upon entering the subconscious of a psychopathic killer. But one thing I do know is that there's nothing more disturbing than the depths of the human mind.
Patient number 13, or Axelrod as we like to call him, is one of our older patients. He has been with us nearly since the beginning, when we first began to receive funding from Vanica Industries. However, lately he has been experiencing difficulty cooperating with the other patients, and we fear his mental and physical conditions have been deteriorating at an accelerated rate. His hallucinations appear to have grown so vivid and incapacitating that we have selected him for our first patient to undergo the invasive pathway procedure in order to locate the source of the problem, isolate it, and remove it. We feel confident that there is a 90.5% chance of success. Has never actually been tested.
You look so scary.
evening, and welcome to my playground, the dreamscape. In your everyday frame of reference, you will live mental illness as your handicap. In my world, it is absolute freedom. I recommend you stay on the path while you struggle to remain conscious of it. Should you depart from it, you will become utterly lost. But if you do follow this pathway through my mind, you will find terror. You will feel my pain. Do as you want, but this is my game. That's why we call it the Psychopath.